Election Day. Lincoln and Douglas were talking about what would happen on that day.
I think you will win the election.
Yeah, we have people by our side, so we don't know.
Even though you have people, I don't have the amount of people you have.
Republican Party candidate Abraham Lincoln becomes the 16th president of the United States.
I propose an unamendable amendment to the Constitution that would guarantee forever the right to hold slaves in the states south of the Compromise Line.
The compromise bill received little support. Slavery in the West was no longer the issue.
Hey, we're free! Woo!
Many Southerners believed that the North had put an abolitionist in the White House. They felt that secession was their only choice. Mississippi.
Mississippi, Florida, Alabama, Georgia, Louisiana, and Texas all committed to secession in 1861. These states formed the Confederate States of America.
Elect Jefferson Davis as the president and draft a constitution which mimics that of the United States except for the explicit enjoyment of slavery.
Under public pressure, sends provisions to the previously unmanned garrison and notifies the secessionists of his intentions. Jefferson Davis takes the decisions to fire on the unnamed boat, which leads to surrender and evacuation of the federal troops. Congress approves the involvement by the troops. The Union multiplies out of a compulsion to use the old soldiers of the play. They're disposed. The constituting war full departure from a policy turning away black soldiers keen to enlist.
All of these that once were my slaves, they want to fight me. So we can enlist and we need all the physical forces.
We are not fighting like slaves, but as free men by your side.
Proclamation stating,
slaves inside the rebelling confederacy are there forward and forever free.
Applying to over 3 million of the approximately 4 million slaves in the whole of America at the time of the conflict. The proclamation only applied to the confederacy, not the slave states still in the Union or the areas under Union Army authority. The proclamation added the abolition of slavery to Lincoln's good of uniting the Union. The Nation's First Conscription Act is passed by Congress. The wealthy take advantage of $300, exception free to avoid slavery. Military success strengthened Lincoln's election campaign against the dovish Democrat General George McClellan. Lincoln is re-elected, carrying the Electoral College vote and a slim majority of the popular vote.
into electoral chaos, a group of Confederate sympathists from Maryland plot to assassinate President Lincoln, his vice president, and Secretary of War. Lincoln is shot in his box out of the Ford Theater in Washington, D.C., by John Wilkes Booth, and dies early the rest morning, the next morning. His secretaries escape similar safe. The conspirators be arrested and hung. Andrew Johnson becomes president. On December 18, 1865, a constitutional amendment to forever abolish slavery in the United States was announced. Although many slaves had been declared free by President Lincoln's Emancipation Proclamation 2 years earlier, their status after the Civil War was uncertain. Indeed, a constitutional amendment to abolish slavery had originally been proposed in 1863 and was passed by the Senate in April of 1864. But the law faced trouble in the House of Representatives after an initial vote, month of debate and negotiations, and President Lincoln's re-election. The House finally passed the amendment in January 1865. But before it could be added to the Constitution, it was necessary that 2 or 3 of the states, 27 out of then total 36, ratify it. Northern states quickly did so. Many southern states were reluctant, but they slowly joined. Audio Jungle.